Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Kati and today I will talk about all the books I read in February and March. It feels so weird filming a wrap-up after too many weeks, but I'm doing it and this is gonna be great. I'm changing my wrap-ups a little bit for now, or at least for a while. They're gonna be bi-monthly wrap-ups because I don't read that many books, so I think this is better because you can have more book recommendations in just one video. Also, I will change the sections, and there's gonna be the wrap-up section, then the DNF section in case I have a DNF, then the currently reading, and that's it. I won't have a TBR because I don't follow them, I just fool myself, so I will avoid TBRs at all costs. In February, I only read two books, and they were two audiobooks because I don't know why. I read physically, but I just don't finish the books, and I finish audiobooks because obviously they are so quick to listen to. The first book I finished was Blue Lily, Lily Blue by Maggie Stiefvater. And well, talking about the synopsis, of course I cannot say it because it will give you spoilers, but I can say that this book was more about character development and the feelings and the emotions and what the characters were going through, the impact of the other books, and also the impact of what is happening right now in their lives. When I started reading this series, I knew that some people said that it was amazing, and others said that it was very slow and that nothing happened. And with the first book, I fell in love. You can watch it on my first wrap-up ever. That's where I talk about it. But then the second book was not good, in my opinion, was a disappointment. And this third book was also a disappointment. Now I'm wondering if the series is actually for me because I didn't really like it. I feel like the storyline went nowhere, and that's a huge problem for me. I'm more a plot-driven reader than a character-driven reader. That's what I noticed. So if the plot is really boring, I tend to just stop reading. And for me, this was like that. I felt like so many things happened, and at the same time, the plot didn't move, which was very frustrating. I felt like the boys were advancing with the ley line and the mystery and finding Glendower, and then something changed. They didn't understand what was going on, and that was basically what happens in each book, I feel. The ley line is just a bitch, and she does whatever she wants, and that's it. That's the whole series. Also, this book was very sad and had many heavy topics that was just depressing, but I didn't really care about the characters and I didn't really care about their relationships, but I get that the book was all about sadness. The last thing I have to say about this book is that I just want a conclusion. Like, I want to know what happens with the ley line and with Glendower and with them, with the romance too. The romance was great in the first book, and here I just didn't really like it. I didn't care, but I want to know what's the conclusion. I also know from other BookTube videos that the ending is quite sad as well, so I don't know. I will finish the series. I will read the last one, but I have no expectations. The second book I read in February was The Maze Runner by James Dashner. I have here my Spanish copy. This was a reread for me, and I won't talk about it that much. I'm just gonna mention that I love it, it's my favorite in the series, and I think it's brilliant. It has a great premise, great characters, and it's one of those trilogies and series like The Hunger Games and Harry Potter that I think everyone has to give it a chance at least. If you like YA, if you like dystopian, this is the book for you. If you want to know more of my thoughts, more details and spoilers about that trilogy, I will leave here in the card and in the description the link to my video in which I review the whole Maze Runner trilogy. Then we start with March, and March was a better month for me. I actually finished more books, and I read my first nonfiction. The first book I finished was The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Klune. This was as an audiobook as well, and I already have a full review all about the book, which I will link also in the cards and in the description so you can see it. The only thing I can say about it is that it was a very cozy book with many great quotes and a very unique and funny writing style. It has representation and fantasy fantasy, but the story is more about the heart of the characters and the development of their relationships. I recommend this book if you like fiction and also if you want to read more about LGBTQ plus representation. Next book I finished was a paperback, actually. I finally finished something that was not an audiobook, and this is Jacoby. I mentioned this book in my first book haul, and I said that I was reading it. I was on page like 109 or something, and I was loving it, and I was loving it, and then I didn't. This book actually has a great premise, a very intriguing one, and the relationship of the main characters is amazing. Jacoby and Abigail have great chemistry, and they actually make a great team solving crimes, which is what this book is about. One thing I have to say is that I related to Abigail sometimes. I liked her personality and her jokes, and overall the way she acted, that was good. Another great thing about it was Jacoby as a character, because it really reminded me of Sherlock Holmes in this new version for this story, which was well done, in my opinion. One thing I never understood, and I'm just searching for it. Here it is. There is this chapter that says nothing, practically. Just says, by request of my employer, the contents of chapter 13 had been omitted. I just didn't get it. If you have read it, please tell me what did I miss there, because I didn't get it. I thought that later on they were going to show that chapter, or they were going to mention something that we didn't even know, so we were going to say like, oh, it was in that chapter, but they didn't, so I didn't really get that. And the action parts weren't very great for me. I have said before on my channel that I don't really like action moments in books, because I really don't like them usually. Here the action parts came with the ending, and the ending was quite underwhelming, so I really don't know what to think about this. I don't think it's a bad book, but I think it wasn't for me. The thing for me with supernatural things, that being books, movies, or TV shows, is that they are usually a hit or miss. And this time it was a miss. There's not many supernatural media that I actually love or even like, and this was the case for Jacoby. I recommend this to you if you love supernatural books or movies or TV, because then you will enjoy it even more. The next book I finished was The Scourge Trials by James Dashner, which was part of my reread of The Maze Runner, which obviously I will talk about in more detail in my video. But for now, the thing that I can say about the book is that it was great up until the middle, and then everything gets weird. I didn't like it as much as the first one, but it wasn't bad. It was good. I talk about more about the plot and spoilers and characters and relationships in my video, so if you want to, you can watch it there. Then I finished Percy Jackson and the Titan's Curse by Rick Riordan. I'm finally catching up on this series. I've read the two books, I think, in 2019, and then I stopped, but I want to finish the whole series, obviously. This book, I have to say that it has a darker story. From the beginning, we kind of set a cold atmosphere for the characters, for the storyline, and yeah, it is very dark and grim and sad. We have many new characters, and I felt like we were only getting to know them when they left, so I don't know how I feel about that. I forgot, I cannot say the actual premise of this book because of the spoilers, but you all know Percy Jackson, right? I hope you do. A funny thing about this was The Lotus Casino, because I even wrote in my review, The Lotus Casino Strikes Again. That was a huge plot, in my opinion. It was great. It was just so weird, but at the same time so logical, which was very well done. I loved it. I guess this is kind of a spoiler, so skip to this part if you don't want to hear it. Annabeth at the beginning gets lost, and I thought that they were going to get her back quickly, or maybe not so much, but they don't, and it is almost all of the book without Annabeth, and I don't get it. I think she is just a crucial part of the story, and I didn't like that. I didn't like that she wasn't even involved in everything. She was more a damsel in distress in this book, and that was not good for me. Another thing that I noticed from this book was that there was so much death, and it was surprising for a children's book, in my opinion. It was very hard to comprehend. I just think it was a great story, but a very depressing one. It's like the fourth book in Harry Potter, everything gets dark and then it goes darker and darker. I feel this is it for Percy Jackson, and I've seen some reviews that say the same. I don't think this was my favorite book. I don't know which one is my favorite, to be honest. I don't think that I'm connecting enough to this series. I like the books, but it's just that I don't love them like I do love other series. So basically this is not one of my favorite series, but I do think it's great and brilliant how Rick Riordan created all of this world. And the last book that I read was my first non-fiction, and it is called, let me read because it is a very long title, Why You Should Read Children's Books Even Though You Are So Old and Wise by Catherine Rundle. So this is the first nonfiction book that I read, and it was a great experience. Of course, I knew that it was about children's books, middle grade, which is a genre that I really love. I wanted to know the perspective of a writer on how she feels about it, how and why she writes for children. And I agree with everything that she said in that book. I think it's brilliant how children's books are more than that, always, and they are full of hope. I do think that middle grade books or children's books are for everyone, and they can teach you many lessons that even adult books can't. They open your eyes to many emotions, and they remind you of yourself when you were a kid, which is brilliant in my opinion. I love this kind of literature so much. It's the one that I consume the most, that I read the most. I have a video all about them where I give you reasons to read middle grade books and also recommendations. So if you want to watch it, I will leave it here in the cards and in the description below. But yeah, this book was amazing and so comforting because I felt like I could relate to that. I felt understood, and that was just great and brilliant for my first nonfiction book. Now let's go to the DNF section, which this is the first video in which I have a DNF book, and that was Beastly Bones by William Richter. And yeah, this is the second part of Jacoby and was very disappointing. The storyline was so boring, I really couldn't deal with that. And Abigail's attitude changed drastically, I don't know how, but she was brilliant in the first book, and here she was very dumb, and it felt like the plot was more about the romance than about the mystery and the supernatural, which, you know, I don't like romance, so yeah. That was a huge no. I actually was 76% done, but still, I couldn't finish it. I have Goodreads here to check, and I'm only reading two books right now. The first one is the Hans Christian Andersen's Fairy Tales, which I don't have here with me. It's in the kitchen, but I don't want to go. So here you have a picture. I'm liking the book so much. I think all of the fairy tales are very creative and great. I'm in the middle of the book. I'm reading the Snow Queen fairy tale, which is the one I wanted to read the most, so I'm very excited. And the second book is The Battle of the Labyrinth from Percy Jackson, which is the fourth book in the series. And I'm actually liking it, but as I told you, this series is not my favorite, but yeah, it's been good. That was it for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed, please give it a like, share it with all of your friends who like books, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I upload videos every week about movies, books, and TV shows. Here in the screen, I will leave some videos for you to check out, and I will see you next time.